seated. So now we've got two hymns we got to work on. The one we sang about Advent last Sunday, and then this one. It's a great old hymn, and it's the only hymn that we sing when we talk about Bible Sunday. And what are we calling this Bible Sunday for? Well, in the collect was written that we just prayed, was written in the year 1549 by a man named Thomas Cranmer. He was the originator of the first prayer book that was translated and prepared in the vernacular, otherwise known as the English. And Cranmer proclaimed that it's been prayed on this day, on the second Sunday in Advent, all the way, all those years from 1549 on to our day and in our age. It proclaims the importance of getting to know the stories and the teachings of Holy Scripture. It's of utmost concern, and if we expect to be able to do what we pray to do this day, we need to become students of Holy Writ, Scripture. We must hear and read and mark and learn and inwardly digest God's Word. And that inwardly digest is a very powerful thing, because when we feed on the Lord's Word in Scripture, then we are strengthened and we receive His comfort. First of all, it feeds us. We feed ourselves both in body and soul. And I think we all understand that if we don't systematically feed our bodies, we're going to die. It's the same with our soul. It nourishes us, Holy Scripture, and helps us to not only understand life, but it also gives us strength to live a godly, righteous, and sober life for Christ's and God's greater glory. And so it feeds us in that respect, but it also brings us together as the body of Christ Jesus. We do readings, we hear readings on a day, on a Mass day, that's for sure, but daily Bible readings are also inherent in what we are called to do. It's what we are called to do, to read it every single day. And we have the process. You can find it. If you don't understand it, talk to me after the coffee hour or during it. But I'll tell you what it's like. Daily Bible reading is kind of like priming the pump. You know, if you're a person who has a big pump out in your front yard, I know about those things because I used to be a farm boy, well, for about 2-3 weeks. But what was going on with that is sometimes the water just doesn't, it leaks out. And so you have to have a bucket of water and you pour that in and then you start pumping again. So this is kind of a parallel about reading and systematically reading and daily the Holy Scripture. It's priming the pump so that our great feast, Sunday here, when we arrive here, Bible reading, we see not only what was going on in the spiritual palate throughout the week, but also when we arrive here, it all makes sense. Everything gives us more clarity and more sense if we study Scripture on a daily basis. We then individually and corporately understand God much more fully if we are systematically going through Bible study, reading Scripture daily. But it also equips us for life. And I'm not talking about just life in this world, but we understand more fully. We carry with us the knowledge gleaned through our readings. And when we face life's difficulties, and we all do, don't we? When we face life's difficulties, we recall more easily the teachings of the faith because we know them better, because they are familiar with us. Because they are familiar with us, because we are students of Holy Scripture. And so guess what happens when that happens? Life is expanded from the mere temporal, which we all kind of experience day in and day out to the eternal. Therefore, even in the midst of the catastrophic, and we all have had those, and perhaps we'll have more, but even in the midst of the catastrophic events of life, we know personally God's love for us. God loves us, and we are shown then the highs and the lows of our dilemma through the ages. Not only through the ages, but and there that no matter really what we may have to go through and suffer in our day and age, others have gone before, and there will be those who follow after us, and they are on the same journey. We're all being drawn closer to Christ Jesus and eternity. You see, God is at the end of our trek with open arms. He's there waiting for us in the sweet by and by. And so Scripture helps us do what we pray today, to embrace and ever hold fast the blessed hope of everlasting life. You can't get that from reading the newspaper, but you can get it through the Scripture readings. And that's our hope, the hope of everlasting life. We live life with our heart, mind, and soul focused on heaven first and foremost. And that's what we look at. We read Holy Scripture then, and where there is joy. And when we hear Jesus saying things like he tells us this day in today's gospel, guess what? We are joyful. We're not afraid. You see, Advent is a time of new beginnings. We know that. We heard that last Sunday also. And so, read Holy Scripture. Join others who are fed by the Word of God. So if you just have a practical agenda or whatever, you might ask, why do we have to do that? Well, look at the world. Think about what's going on. Can you see what's going on? Why is it so messed up in our life? There are some magnificently beautiful things, but there are some terribly ugly and dastardly deeds we do one to another, and we all sadly witnessed those things. So, it is really quite simple, though, why those things happen. It's a simple declaration. It's not because of some man or woman. It's not because of a Republican or a Democrat or a fat and skinny person or a black or white or whatever, or tall or short person or young or old. Here's the bottom line of why these terrible things happen. It's very simple to understand. There are two types of human beings. The godly, those who know God, and the godless, those who know him not. And therein lies the preponderance of sin and pain and anguish. Godlessness. That's the ingredient. And so, thanks be to God that we are going to read the owner's manual so that we can travel toward him in our life. It's a lifelong process, and you just may do something magnificent that you just didn't know you could. You just may also not only grow in God's grace, but save someone's soul.